Hello students, today we are starting our lecture on JSP technology. JSP stands for Java Server Pages. In this lecture, we will see what is JSP, where we can use JSP, how we can implement this JSP technology. So let us start with what is JSP. JSP technology is used to create web application just like servlet technology. It can be thought of as an extension to a servlet because it provides more functionality than servlet, such as expression language, JSTL, etc. A JSP page consists of HTML tags and JSP tags. The JSP pages are easier to maintain than servlet because we can separate designing and development. It provides some additional features such as expression language, custom tag, etc. Previously, we have seen that the servlet technology was used for creating web applications. Now, we have another term, JSP, which is also used for creating web application. But the different criteria is that in JSP technology, we are maintaining both parts differently, designing and development. Whereas in servlet technology, we were merging all these two parts into a single file. So there are several advantages of JSP over the servlet. These are, first is extension to servlet. Second is easy to maintain. The third is fast development. And the fourth is less code than servlet. Extension to servlet. As seen in previous slide, we can say that the JSP is extension of servlet technology because there are many more features in JSP technology compared to servlet. For example, expression language, tag library, etc. Easy to maintain. So in previous slide we have also seen that there are different two parts, business logic and presentation part. In JSP, these two parts are kept separately, whereas in servlet we are merging these two parts. So it is easy to maintain the JSP page compared to servlet class. Fast development. We can develop the JSP page faster than servlet because servlet needs the updated and recompiled, whereas in JSP we need not to recompile the each and every time which we have made changes. Less code than servlet. In JSP we have rich tag library which we can use for developing JSP page, whereas in servlet we have to create classes, methods, parameters, so our code part is larger than the JSP page. So let us start with the life cycle of JSP page. There are different four phases of JSP life cycle. The first is compilation, second is initialization, third is execution, and the fourth is cleanup. Let us see in the block diagram life cycle of JSP. There are main three methods. The first is JSP init method. The second is JSP service, and the third is destroy. When the JSP is initialized, this init method is called same as servlet, but the name is different here, which is JSP init. When the request response take place, this phase is included in JSP service method, which is exactly working same as service method of servlet class. Then the last method is JSP destroy method, which is same as destroy method of servlet class. Now let us see the different phases. First is JSP compilation. The compilation process involves three steps. First is parsing the JSP. Second is turning the JSP into servlet. Third is compiling the servlet. In compilation, First, JSP is parsed. Parsed means read, it is read out and arranged according to grammar. And the second is we have to convert that JSP page into servlet. And then this servlet is need to be compiled for the execution. The next phase is JSP initialization. When a container loads a JSP, it invokes the JSP init method before servicing any request. When any request comes into a browser, first it invokes the JSP init method before doing anything. Typically, initialization is performed only once, and as with the servlet init method, you generally initialize database connections, open files and create lookup tables in the JSP init method. So basically we are using this JSP init method for initializing parameters, creating database connections, for creating lookup tables, etc. So next is the JSP execution phase. This phase of JSP lifecycle represents all interaction with request until the JSP is destroyed. It means that before JSP initialized and up to destroy phase, in between these two phases, this phase is working, means the JSP execution, where request response term take place. Whenever a browser requests a JSP and the page has been loaded into a browser, the JSP engine invokes the JSP service method in the JSP. When the request comes, then the browser invokes the JSP service method. The JSP service method takes an parameters as an argument that are HTTP servlet request and HTTP servlet response. This method takes objects of these two classes, which are HTTP servlet request, HTTP servlet response. Then the next phase is JSP cleanup. The destruction phase of the JSP lifecycle represents when a JSP is being removed from use by the container. When the browser has completed the use of the JSP page, then this method is called. The method is JSP destroy method, and this method is same as destroy method of service method. And with this method, request response objects which were created in JSP execution phase, those were HTTP servlet response, HTTP servlet request. These two objects will be destroyed in this phase also. So these were the lifecycle of JSP. In this lecture, we have seen that what is JSP, what are the advantages of JSP over the servlet, and the lifecycle of the JSP. In next lecture, we will see JSP architecture, means how JSP will work, and the JSP scripting element. Using this JSP scripting element, we can design the JSP page. Thank you.